And so I remember when Aubry first put in two frogs in Lone Grove, west of 35. So where he's at now was originally a Shoney's.
Shoney's restaurant.
And it wasn't there for very long. They built that building. They were there for a few years. And then all of the Shoney's in the south and in this area
closed.
So Aubry and his wife buy this building, and they turn it into two frogs. And back in the day, he would bring some artists in to the place, some blues guys, and there was this piano player named Jack who lived in Ardmore who would play on the weekends. Well, he just did the same thing at the one in Ardmore that's still there. But he has brought some legendary shows to Ardmore, Oklahoma.
Oh, absolutely.
I saw, how many times have you eaten in that restaurant? A dozen or more, at least?
Oh, at least.
This year?
Yeah. So,
within the last year, it's been more than a dozen.
So you know how small that place is.
Yeah.
It's not a very big restaurant.
And, you know, the cool thing about it is it's so good, but even on a Friday or Saturday night, you don't have to wait.
No, you've always
There's really hardly no wait time.
Great atmosphere, great food.
Food's good.
Great service every time.
And his little back private bar area back there, if you're in the know to go back there, you never know who you might see there.
That's hey, bro, true. I saw Joe Bonamassa play live in Two Frogs.
Wow.
I've seen Eric Gales play live in Two Frogs. I've seen The Answer, who was the opener on an AC/DC tour. Play
and he would just buy those bands like a Chiro did.
Yep,
they're rolling through. They need a Tuesday. What's it going to cost me? $100 and you beat them.
Shooter Jennings.
Yep,
in Two Frogs.
I saw Mountain Leslie West.
Mountain. I was at that show. I've seen the Cadillac 3 in Two Frogs.
Brett Michaels after parties.
I saw Brett Michaels full band play in there.
Wow.
I've seen Frank Hannon numerous times.
Frankie Perez.
A bunch. Aranda. Mike Pierce.
Yeah.
Like, it's an incredible room. But he doesn't just book these touring bands anymore. He's learned that every show he does needs to be a one-off special event that isn't happening anywhere else.
Or pair up the artists like the last time. When me and Jeff were eating there, and, you know, this is like a shit-yourself moment. We're eating, and in walks Billy G. Gibbons.
I'm like, Max, look, there's Billy.
There's Willie G. right there. And, you know, it's my hero, one of my heroes. But
It could be Willie G. or it could be Billy Bob Thornton.
Right.
We just don't know.
Right. Or Kevin Costner.
So when we walk back into Aubrey's little
area.
Private area back there, who all was sitting at that table?
He had Chris Dayton from Trouble, Johnny Winter.
Oh, no.
Archangels. He's his drummer.
Chris Layton. There was Ian Moore.
Ian Moore.
Billy Gibbons.
Who was the other guy?
That would be
Aubry was there.
Yep.
There's someone else there.
And there was one other guy there, but the crazy part about it was we told him we were from Oklahoma City, and I've heard this more than once. It's like these guys said, "Oh, you're from Oklahoma City," and we were talking about the Samurai, and a Chiro's name come up, and Ian Moore and Chris Staten go. Man, dude, there's a guy there that used to play at that Samurai.
Badass guitar player.
Badass guitar player. You guys might know who that is.
Without
I didn't even bat an eye.
We both said it at the same time.
His name, Otis Watkins. That's it. You know. And then they were sad that he passed away.
What happened to him? I go, he died. And they're like, oh.
The whole thing
It's like, oh.
There went the balloon.